I'll show you in 4 easy steps how to always get a good voiceover mix in DaVinci Resolve. This video is meant when you have trouble achieving a good voiceover sound, and will give a fixed framework and workflow to achieve a good result every time. Make sure your mixer and meter windows are activated. We're going to use the audio of this video clip. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. 1. Start by making sure the audio has a certain volume. Right-click on the audio clip and select Normalize Audio. Select ITU RBS 1770-4. Set the target level to -3 and the target loudness to -16 LKFS. This will give you enough headroom and will give you your basis volume for every time you do a vocal processing. Do this for every vocal clip you have. 2. We will now give the voice more presence and authority by using the vocal channel plugin. Go to the right to the mixer and click on the plus to add an effect. Channel, Fairlight effects, and select the vocal channel. Remove possible low-end rumble by enabling the high pass. Sweep it up until you hear that the voice gets thin and then back up a bit. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to. Now we will add some authority by adding low frequencies. First, click for a more suitable EQ type. Just drag to around 200 Hz and then drag up to boost. You can use the controls too, of course. Drag to the right to increase the boosted frequency. Find a balance where it sounds full but not muddy. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like. Every voice is different, so experiment what fits your voice the best. Now we want more presence. Go to the high frequencies and select the other EQ type again. Simply drag to around 5000 Hz and move up. Find a balance by dragging the EQ around. Like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe. Don't overdo the high frequency boost. Overdoing the boost too much can make your voice sound unpleasant and harsh. 3. Now we want to make the vocal pop more. For that, we enable the compressor to even out the dynamics. If I look at this meter, I will see that the peak is around -8 and the lowest around -20. So let's set the threshold around -20. That is the baseline, which above the compressor will do its work. Now we dial in the ratio. That is the ratio of how much every decibel above the threshold will be compressed. So for instance, 4 to 1 will reduce every decibel above the threshold by a factor of 4. Subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. 4 is a good starting point. Lower values will sound more natural. I like this video. And higher values will give more of a radio presenter type of voice. I like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. I'll settle with 4 for now. The reaction can be set from fast to slow. Really fast sounds more in your face and up front. I like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. I like this video. While slower is more relaxed. I like this video. Please remember to subscribe. To this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video.
I'll be on the fast side. Now the vocal will sound a little bit less loud than when we started out due to the compression. We had peaks around -8 and now it's less. So let's turn up the gain to have the peaks again at -8.
Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this.
Now go back to the EQ and fine-tune the sound. Compression can change the sound a bit.
Channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe.
If you're happy with the sound and always record the vocal the same way, you can store this as a preset, which will save you a lot of time the next time you do it. Just fine-tune the settings a little bit. 4. As a final touch, we will apply a limiting. Go to Dynamics, Fairlight Effects and select a limiter. Here we will grab the few tiny peaks to make sure the audio will translate well when we do the final export. Just turn down the threshold until you see a few peaks happening above the line. Subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to don't do it too much, it will sound bad. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. This is just a safety measure. So we went from this. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Please remember to this. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Follow these steps and you will always have a great sounding voiceover in DaVinci Resolve. Now, if you want to learn more about improving mixes and voice, check out the video displayed on screen right now.